Good morning from Panhandle Outdoors, America's only daily outdoor TV show. Your source for fishing, hunting, and information for folks who enjoy the great outdoors. Now sit back, relax. It's Panhandle Outdoors.
Good morning, folks. Welcome to Panhandle Outdoors. I'm Winston Chester. I'm glad you're here this morning. We're bringing you America's only daily outdoor TV show. We say that not to be bragging, but just to let y'all know we have something this special here in the Florida Panhandle because of folks like you and where we live. And that's the only way we can keep on going like this. And I appreciate the viewership and hard work Jeff does and Gail does. And all I do is sit here and run my mouth. I got the easy part. High today, 68. Low, 51. Pretty day. Water temperature, we talked about it now. The water temperature did exactly like I thought it was going to do. Remember, it jumped up to 66. Well, at the end of the pier, it's 63.1. That's what we said. So, on my fishing report, we're going to talk about some of the things happening with 63-degree water temperature. But it's about where we thought it's going to be, but it's going to be going up soon, a little bit more. Speaking of going up, take a look at our river readings. The Apalachicola Blountstown, 17.5, and it's pretty high. It's up in that, really on up in there. 17.5 foot, Apalachicola. The Choctachy, looking at it, it's going up 11.6. Going to level off, though, next day or two. Got some requests to do the Chipola River, and I will do the Chipola River on occasion. We'll give you that reading on occasion, okay? One of our viewers requested that. Our tide chart brought to us by Kent Forest Lawn. Now, you're talking about a good, strong tide. Check this out. We're looking at a high tide at 119 right here in the middle of the day, and then low at 104 after midnight. A great tide tomorrow. We're really in it's going to be a nice weekend to get out there on the water. The wind now is going to be south-southeast at about 10. We can live with that. It's still a little windy at places, but I know most of y'all got big old boats. Unlike me, I got a little boat, so I got to be careful out there. But, you big fancy boats, y'all are going to be in good shape. And the river bateaus, y'all going to be in good shape. All right, let's take a break. We'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Let's get through some of these pictures that you sent in locally, and really good one. We're going to talk about this duck season. Folks, we've had a really good duck season. And my neighbor up there in Southport, young Colby Sims, loves to duck hunt. He stays in contact with me. I was supposed to go duck hunting with him this year, and we're going to get our schedules together. I did have a great duck hunt with Braden Harris and the other boys up there. But anyway, Colby excited, told me that last weekend he got this nice duck up there. I won't tell you exactly where he shot it, but it was tagged. And you know how I get excited. I said, that is cool. Where was it tagged? He texted me back. It was tagged in Maine. So it came all the way. That duck right there. You can see the tag. See that metal piece right there? That's the tag. And now, back when I did it, I had to, send letters off and everything else. But now you just get on the computer and just type the numbers in. And boom, 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 it tells you it's tagged up there in Maine. So good job, Colby. And he really hit the ducks hard this year, had a great year in freshwater and in the bay system. That's a nice redhead there. Colby Sims, my neighbor up there in Southport. Always got a big old smile on his face. I had to run this by you because I ran across it. We're talking about black bear hunting. This is 2021 harvest, okay? It ended up, but look at the number of black bear, and this is a different way, three-day hunt, a youth hunt, archery, and the harvest on those folks, 3,000, at the bottom left, 3,464, and 47% were females, so obviously muzzleloader and regular firearms got most of them, and I like the last category, they just unknown how it died, but so anyway, that's a big black bear harvest up there in Virginia. That's been just a custom up there for years ago. Let me read this here. This is great. This is one of our viewers. This is Adam Mack. Okay, Winston, years ago I decided to hunt for trophy bass and had very good results. My biggest was 14 pounds. My story is about one day when I spotted a nice bed, I marked it, and came around with a little more stealth. I anchored and cleaned the deck to make sure nothing bad happened. I could see the buck on the bed and the big female on the outside edge. So I made a few casts, caught the buck, and put him in the live well. And in no time, the female moved onto the bed, which surprised me. I made a few casts and hooked up. I knew she was a hog when she hit the surface, finally got her to the boat, weighed her. How about 11 pounds? I'm pumped. Just as I was going to release her, I started moving on her bed, another hog. I put 11 pounds in live oil, made a few casts, and hooked up again. Game on, heart pumping out of my chest, got her a net. Can you believe a 12 pound, a day I will never forget. Caught right here in Panama City, Alan Mack. Folks, you catch a 12 pound or 11 pounder, that's something special. Great job, Adam Mack. That is Mack's True Big Bass. What a great job. Glad you got her pictures of it. And thank you for sharing that story. What a great story. These are just some sign of springtime. What makes this special, Wendy planted this when she and Walter first got married and lived across the road from us, and they bloom out. It's the first one I see every year, so I just sent her the picture the other day, the jasmine. I had to take this picture down at Howard Creek. Gail and I were down there, Tuesday, Wednesday of this week. This is a boat landing in Howard Creek. What makes this picture unique? How many cars and trucks do you see? None. This is a rare occasion for Howard Creek. I don't care what time of the year or what time of the day it was, but the water's high. You can see the water's a little bit high coming up there, but Howard Creek with nobody there. So I don't know. That just don't happen much. And it probably, you want to see it that way this weekend. Okay, this is for you entrepreneurs out there. We'll back trailer for cash. This is funny now. This is Pam Peterson Kelly. Just at a backyard shot. This week she passed. Saw this happen. A swallowtail kite hit a dove. Okay, I got a series. It's sitting on it. Okay, and that's just nature right there. What a great picture, Pam. Got him pinned down. And of course, that was his meal for the day. A yellowtail kite. Okay, good job. Spring is right around the corner. Soon, let the show begin at the ramps. And this is we're gonna see more and more of this. There's so much more to fishing than just catching, and we've talked about this before, just getting out there and do something. This picture, let me explain this picture. This is from Killen, Alabama, and we had Brock Meyer on. She's holding on. I thought she was holding a gun, but she's holding on to a limb. And I think here's the story behind it. I think this is Jordan, we had Brock Meyer on, and I was checking his comments and all. I think this is his grandmother, his mama. I'm going to find out who this is. And if she's on, this is her, we got to get her to come on the show and talk about how at that age you still climb trees and all. Because if it's not, we need to find out who it is. But I just think I got a kick out of that. That's awesome. Still climbing trees. My buddy Rusty Morrison worked at Mosley for years and great bass fisherman. Good job, Rusty Morrison. I think he's still up there at Mosley. Okay, let's go ahead and take our break, and we'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. Just a couple more pictures. I want to finish up on those, and I got to show this one right here because I promised him I'd have it on Friday morning. G.G. Hunt's up there in Chipley. Hey, Winston, caught my biggest bass today, 11 and 3/4 pounds and 28 inches long, up in Washington County, and Washington County has some big bass. And here it is right here. That's 11 and 3/4 pound. And listen, back in the old days, you just throw a couple of pieces of lead in the mouth and make sure it ran off to 12 pounds. That is a fine bass up there in Washington County. Congratulations. Robin Holland sent this into Panama City Fishing, and they told me that, she said, my mama slayed today, 72 years old and still killing it. Is that not a wonderful picture? I got a message from Panama City Fishing page. They had this picture had 1,100 likes on it. I love to see that. That is great. Well, right here, Winston Chester, this post got 1,100 likes. That's awesome. Just real proud of y'all. Okay, now let's go to something not as pleasant. Check this out. You see this Yamaha jet ski? It's got it right there. Now, this story behind this. This is my neighbor's jet ski that was stolen this past Monday. And I got permission to put this on my show because out in our neighborhood, I've been there 40 plus years and never had anything stolen. So when this happened, and Sunday afternoon, there was two guys out on a jet ski, and it was pretty rough, they were running around. But basically, I wrote down, I'm going to show you on Google Earth, where, and when I get back to the fishing port, I'll show you exactly where it's taken from. But anyway, Monday around 9 o'clock, 8:37, because I had it on camera, a man came up on a jet ski, got on the dock, lowered the wave runner into the water, towed his jet ski behind this wave runner, and that was probably the same two people that had been out there on Sunday afternoon, acting like they were just playing around jet skiing, but boy, they were scouting and scoping the place out. And I'm going to personally offer rewards for it. I don't know if there's rewards offered, and it's just the idea of somebody, this family they stole it from, that family with kids, hardworking couple that worked hard, and it's, you know, here's a thief coming up and stealing that Yamaha jet ski. And I'm going to give you more information on about it. There's another picture of it right there. And if you see, if you remember anybody, it's, Monday morning, seeing anybody at a boat ramps with two jet skis, or that, they've got it on video, and the sheriff's department's on top of it. They've got fingerprints, so they feel pretty good about it at this point in time. But if anybody, if all of a sudden somebody, a jet ski showed up in someone's backyard, that maybe the jet ski's nicer. Well, anyway, we won't go there. But anyway, just call me. Let me know, and I will get in touch with the sheriff's office, and we'll try to solve this. And just be careful. Not be careful. Just try to protect your stuff best you can. It's a shame something like that happens. But anyway, don't forget, this weekend, the rodeo up here, Youngstown and Fountain. Let's go to something more pleasant. Shout-out Temple. And you know the good they do for young people. It's going to be starting Friday and Saturday today. And also, Wheels and Water, you can hit both of them, because you're up there in the same neck of the woods, up there in the Compass Lake area. So make sure that, in fact, I'm going to be there tonight. I'm going to try to get there this afternoon, if all goes well, if my schedule fits in. I'm going to try to get there this afternoon, shoot some video, and try to eat some of that lobster. I may listen to some of that music and see if they call me up on stage to sing with them. But if not, I just sit out there and listen to them. But anyway, some good things going on. And it's been we've had a good week here on Panhandle Outdoors. We've got a couple new sponsors coming on. I'm tickled about that. You saw the video. We've had a good show this week. We had Brock Meyer. I got some really good responses from y'all that y'all really enjoyed. Brock Meyer coming on, a young man who's been fishing 3 or 4 years and now has a guide service. And I was telling Jeff before the show, it's just a testimonial. No matter where you're coming from, if you just have this love and passion for fishing, you can learn this area, and you can learn it in a relatively short time. You don't have to be a long time, you know, five generations fishing family and all to learn how to fish. And Brock is a testimonial for that. I'm just so glad he's doing that well in it. He's such a nice, well-mannered young man, and it reflected in some of the results that y'all sent to me. So thank you, Brock, for coming on. We're going to have him back on, and we've got a lot of guests coming on next week. It's been a good week, though, on Panhandle Outdoors. We've been real, real pleased with everything. So let's go ahead and get ready for our drawing. I got another good thing to happen. I wrote myself a note. I'm going to be Travis and his wife Sandy are going to be there with me. Travis runs our Panhandle Outdoor shop. He called me the other day. He was excited. Folks, we had a $500 order from one guy for the Panhandle Outdoor shop on shirts and everything. And the guy, he's not from Southport. He's from Ohio. And he loved the show. He's got family and friends and all he wants to give shirts to. And we're just tickled with that. That sets a record for the biggest purchase we ever had at Panhandle Outdoor shop. So we're going to have a commercial coming up pretty soon, and on our shop, and I got Whitney working on that, and we're going to have a commercial going on. And so anyway, you can buy them now, anything you want for birthday present or whatever. You can buy one just for the heck of it. Okay, here we go. Los Angeles Heroes, $25. Joe Ellen from Panama City. Cassidy right there, put them in order. Joe Ellen, Cassidy. Okay, here we go. Second one from Panama City, Tom Platt. All right, Tom. And now let's go to the $20 gift certificate. It's going to be from Carrieville, Candy Strength. All right. And a big red snapper coming all the way. And if I haven't added your name now, maybe resend it. I've been trying to keep up with it. At times we'll get bogged down, but and you can enter any time of the year. And from Lynn Haven, Ron Miller. So Panama City, and we got one from the Cove, one from Panama City, one from Caribbean, and one from Lynn Haven. So covering the panhandle, like what? The Kudzu in Alabama. Let's take a break. We'll come back with our famous Friday fishing report. Welcome back. I don't have the fishing game times. They're over there on the table. I can't reach them. If you need to text me or something, I'll text them back to you, okay? We'll just be flexible today. Let's get with our fish report, our famous Friday fishing report. Again, it's information I've gathered all week. Stop by Blue Water, talk to some other folks at different places. But before we get to the fish, let's look where that, let's zoom into where that jet ski was stolen. I'm going to ask you to, okay, I'll keep everything here in the middle of the screen. There's a Deer Point Dam to the right. Okay, everybody know where you are. Deer Point Dam. I'm going to keep everything in the middle. I'm going to go to my house first, see what Gail's doing. Okay, right in the center of the screen, that's my house right there, okay? See that dock? All right, we're going to go down my road to my neighbor right here. Okay, the long dock right there next to it, that's where it's stolen from. Now, that's Gainer Bayou up right there at the top. So let's zoom back out now. So you see we're in North Bay, Lynn Haven Bridge on left, Deer Point on right. So what I'm thinking, if you think about it, I think probably on a Monday morning, if you're at the boat ramp there at the dam, if you saw somebody loading something up at a dam or at the right there in Lynn Haven boat ramp, or if somebody came across to the Country Club area, Mill Bayou area, you saw something suspicious. I know most of y'all are working on Monday, but anyway, that's where the location of it, okay? Let's move on. Speaking of location, one of the things I wanted to share with you, the squid bite is on. They're catching squid every night. Now, I know everybody, they're all crazy about squid fishing, but I'm going to show you one of the areas they're catching them. I've talked about downtown area, but you can go right down here to St. Andrew. Okay, this is St. Andrew. Okay, and let's see, right, you see this wall right here in the center? You can catch squid right there, all along this wall. You can catch squid. You have some light and everything. Real easy to get to, and you can catch them every night. Now, what are you going to do with squid? Well, you can eat them, the calamari. You can pay for them high price at a restaurant. You can cook them yourself, or you can save them for bait. And squid is the number one go-to bait in the Gulf of Mexico. And we've just caught. I know live bait's good, but I'm talking about fishing all day on a boat and everything. You can't fish without squid. Okay, so we got squid covered. The other thing I wrote down. Let's jump on freshwater real quick. This is our late winter, early spring report, and I wrote down right now we got high water, and on fresh water, and you think about the high water on fresh water, you think about catfishing up in the sloughs, setting out those lines, and when the water starts going down, those catfish will be up there feeding, and they'll come right on out, and so trot lining is good this time of the year. You ain't got to worry about many snakes out there, not that many and all, and but you got to have high water, and you want it coming out, so. And also just tight lining on the bottom out there, like a bit of grantham I talked about this week. So hit all those sloughs with a trot line. Also, freshwater bass fishing. We're right here in that pre-spawn. And by the way, Sunday afternoon up in Sneeds, I'm going to try to be up there at the boat landing. The bass anglers, the young high school guys are going to be up there. Nice setup they got. And they're going to fish Saturday and Sunday for the Bass Federation, for the high school, and I'm gonna be up there interviewing some folks and all, so I hope to see you at a Sneeze boat ramp. It'll be 3 o'clock Sunday afternoon, and we'll check that out and shoot some video and share with you folks that can't make it. So we got that going on. So bass fishing is really good, and it's gonna be, all right, now we'll go to Spanish. We're gonna talk about Spanish right here in this area here. We'll talk about Spanish showing up. The first place you're gonna catch Spanish, and that's where we used to take our kids, are gonna be right here. Off the piers, the Panama City Beach Pier. I'm going to shoot the beach pier right here. You got the beach pier and the county pier. This is the first place you're going to start catching Spanish mackerel. And I imagine if I called out there today, they're going to say, yeah, we've caught a couple here and a couple there, because that's how it starts off. And next week I'm going to bring the results to you again of fishing off the pier with the gotcha plugs and different color combinations. And we, with our scientific theories we put in year after year. But fishing with gotcha plugs off the pier will be something fun to do this weekend. And you're going to, I think you're going to catch a few. The big schools aren't in, but Spanish mackerel will be right around the corner when the Spanish coming in. And again, let's see. I want to make sure that don't forget our bay fishing, getting over to Choctaw River. Choctaw River is high, but again, the Freeport area and all, at the boat ramp there, there's going to be at Ebro, you're going to see some nice fish coming in. I promise you, just get a boat ramp Saturday afternoon and see what they caught. You're going to see some nice brim coming in. Okay, let's jump in. Again, the big thing, the intercoastal waterway has been very productive for about the past month. You've seen Jerry Forehand caught that big old 30-inch redfish. It was 2 weeks ago. Had 30 spots on it. It was 30-inch long. So Jerry sent that picture to us and caught them right there in the intercoastal and in the canal. So and the great thing about fishing in intercoastal, you get out of the weather. You're in some good situations there. Okay, jetty fishing, St. Andrews State Park is in good shape. You can fish off the jetties. Again, the Spanish on an incoming tide, probably starting this weekend. We haven't had a third fog yet, but some of those, what I call scouts, will be coming through there. And so you can catch, throwing a gotcha plug there at the jetties. I want to get on down. I want to get all the way down to St. George Island. Okay, let's skip. By the way, I was out. We're not going to skip it. We're not going to skip Cape San Blas. Gail and I were down this week. Things are looking good. The water's in good shape. The bay fishing is going to really kick off soon in St. Joe Bay. I was looking around and talking to folks at Blue Water. And, yes, off the wall there, they have caught some pompano off the wall, but I think it's just sort of hit and miss there. So I'm not saying pompano in, but they have caught a couple this week off the wall there in St. Joe behind Blue Water. And I'm going to run out of time. Why do I always run out of time? St. George Island fishing is good. we'll leave it like that, and we're going to call Sea Quarters next week and touch base with them. So got to wrap it up for the week. Had a great week, and thank you all for all the replies y'all have given us and all the feedback. And y'all have a great weekend. And today, do something good for your fellow man. Enjoy the great outdoors, and God bless.
Thanks for watching America's only daily outdoor TV show, Panhandle Outdoors with Winston Chester, featuring hunting, fishing, and other activities and information to help you enjoy the great outdoors. Join us next time for Panhandle Outdoors.